We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Spider-Man Spider Shadow Issue 1. This is a miniseries from Marvel Comics from 2021, written by Chip Zdarsky, art by Pasqual, Ferry, colors by Matt Hollingsworth, letters by VC's Joe Caramagna. Phil Noto was the cover artist. I have the variant cover by Ron Lim and Israel Silva. Assistant editor Kat Gregowski, Will Moss editor, CB Sobolski editor in chief. Alright, this is a what if story, but first of all I have to say I really like this cover. It's very well done, and it does give you a little bit of an idea of what you can expect in the book. So we start off with Peter having nightmares. He's restless, can't really sleep, so he goes out web swinging, beats up a couple thugs, and then he gets in a big knockdown drag out with the Hobgoblin. And it's really, really interesting what happens, because they kind of play around with the history here. This is a what if story, so, and being only a four-part series, they don't have time to screw around. So this issue actually takes place right around issue 258 of the Amazing Spider-Man series, and that was some really seminal stories going on at the time. So the Hobgoblin story actually has changed pretty significantly here, and Peter sends a message, but I don't think the message was quite received the way it was intended. He tries to talk to Felicia, that's not working out, and when he goes to talk to Mr. Fantastic about the suit, much like what happened in the actual comic book, Mr. Fantastic tries to warn him that you're playing with fire here, kid, but this time Peter doesn't listen. And things go very wrong very quickly. And he ends up running into the Hobgoblin again, and this time one of his loved ones is put at risk, and it doesn't look good. So Peter's pushed to the edge in a way that we haven't seen very often. So pretty interesting stuff. This is really well written, and clearly they did some research before starting this project, which is shocking to me that somebody at Marvel actually took time to, I don't know, read some history. So I thought it was handled very maturely, very well done. It's a very interesting book, and it's written in a style that surprisingly is accessible by different age groups. It's rated T for teen, and I think that's perfectly appropriate. I have to say that although I didn't used to like Chip Zdarsky's work, he has improved dramatically over the last couple of years, and this really shows that he has potential to be one of the best writers currently at Marvel, probably in the top three, right under Larry Hama and Peter David. So this is probably the best Spider-Man book on the market right now, and he should be writing Spider-Man if he's going to write this well. So if you're looking for a Spider-Man book that actually has Spider-Man acting like Peter Parker, then this is probably it. Even though it's a what-if story and it's gonna end in tears, it's got a lot of potential to be a very, very good story. So hopefully Zdarsky won't drop the ball, but the story is really good. The art is mostly good. I didn't have a problem with the overall concepts and perspective shots. The only thing I didn't like was sometimes people's faces look a little square, and I know that's the style the guy's going with, but kind of bothered me a bit, mostly on Reed Richards. And facial hair. The guy makes it look like Peter Parker has mange or something, so maybe don't go with that. But overall, it's acceptable art. The color scheme is great, especially around the fire. The colors are fantastic. So I think the art team did a decent job. It's enough that it didn't annoy me beyond words, like usually happens in Marvel. The only real negative is the paper quality is trash, like usual, because it's Marvel. So for $5, you are getting a little bit of an inferior product, so you might want to hold off for the trade paperback to get better quality paper, but we'll see how it plays out. Until then, this is a recommend. I would try and find it for about $4 or $3.50 if you can, but overall it's a decent product, and the story has been really fun so far. So we'll see how next issue goes. Until then, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links to my Teespring store, Patreon, and Streamlabs are all in the description, and as always, we hope to see you on the next one.